This conference will now be recorded.
Okay, good morning all. In last class we discussed some energy band diagrams and also we discussed some diode resistance and diode models, right? And some diode specifications. Today also we discuss in detail about diode models, right? In general, while solving the problems, we cannot replace each and every time diode with p-type material, n-type material, and forward bias depletion region. We cannot analyze like that, right? Only two cases, whether it is a diode connected in forward bias or diode connected in reverse bias. When diode connected in forward bias, then what is the equivalent circuit? When diode connected in reverse bias, and what is the equivalent circuit? Like that, right? And coming to the diode models, it is ideal diode. There are a few characteristics. One is the RF diode forward resistance is equal to 0 ohms and V gamma diode cut-in voltage 0 volt and RR is the reverse resistance of a diode that is equal to infinity. Right? Okay, in this case, first case ideal diode, we consider the three parameters. I think all are ideal values. RF is equal to 0, V gamma is equal to 0, RR is equal to infinite resistance. Then what happens when diode is in forward bias means simply it will act as a short circuit. When diode is in reverse bias, simply it will act as an open circuit. Right? So this is the VI characteristics here. That means the current flows through the diode just greater than 0 volts. Remember, forward bias, it will act as a short circuit. AC means short circuit. OC means open circuit. When it is in reverse bias, open circuit. So that is the one ideal diode model. Coming to the second model, something like a simplified model. Okay, again in three parameters, only one parameter is considered. RF is equal to 0, RR is equal to infinity. Only V gamma is equal to finite. Only V gamma is equal to finite. Right? Now in this case, what happened means when V greater than V gamma, greater than or is equal to V gamma, then only current flows through the device. So equivalent one is ideal diode, short circuit, and consider the V gamma. Or you know, V gamma some 0.72. Okay, 0.6 to 0.7 volts. When it is reverse bias, it is simply act as a open circuit. Okay, when it is forward bias, what is the opposition here? V gamma is the opposition. Up to V gamma, current is equal to 0. When V applied voltage greater than or equal to V gamma, then only current flows through the PN junction diode. Remember this one. Then third one also simplified model. Now we now consider the two parameters. Here in second case, one parameter is practical parameter, that is V gamma. In third case, two parameters. Okay, these two parameters are the practical values. What is RF? RF is the diode forward resistance, that is equal to finite value. And V gamma also finite voltage. Now, still in this case, RR is equal to infinity ohms. Now, what happens means, when applied voltage V greater than V gamma, the current not increases abrupt change. Okay, it increases linearly. Okay, with respect to RF, right? Diode forward resistance. The current increases linearly when V greater than V gamma. This is the equivalent circuit model. Anode, cathode, what is equivalent V gamma and RF in forward bias. In reverse bias, it is open circuit. Why? Because RR is equal to infinity. Okay, here RR is equal to infinity. So in reverse bias, it is simply act as an open circuit. Open circuit, you know that current is equal to 0. Now come to the fourth model. It is also called piecewise linear approximation model. Okay, to solve the engineering problems, right, the people use the fourth model, piecewise linear. That means, okay, the VI characteristics of a PN junction is approximated as a linear, piecewise linear. Okay, during this, when V greater than V gamma, actually what is current shape, exponential shape. But here approximation is a linear approximation. Similarly, here also in reverse bias also, okay, up to less than breakdown voltage, okay, this is also considered as a linear, right? Okay, now in fourth model, all are practical values. What are the parameters here? RF diode resistance finite ohm, V gamma cut-in voltage finite, and RR very large, right? Okay, that means in reverse bias also consider the very large resistance. Now what is the equivalent circuit model here? In forward bias, ideal diode short circuit, there is a V gamma, okay, up to this one is V gamma. Then there is a RF. Okay, due to this RF, what happens means current increases linearly. Okay, dynamic resistance, where RF is dynamic resistance. Coming to the reverse bias. Okay, so far in first three cases, in three ideal model, simplified model two, or simplified model three, all these models in reverse bias, diode act as a open circuit. Current is equal to zero. But in piecewise linear approximation model, what is the equivalent one? That is replaced with a large resistor, right? Anode to cathode, current flows through the anode to cathode through a very, very large resistor. Okay, what is the resistance in the range of? That resistance in the range of mega ohms, very, very large. So that the current measured between anode to cathode through very large resistances, very, very small amount of current goes through the device. Okay, this is a very simple topic here, diode models, right? Once again here, in diode model, ideal diode, okay, all are ideal values. All these parameters are ideal values. What are the parameters? RF, dynamic resistance, V gamma, and reverse resistance. Now this is the characteristics, VI characteristics. And what is the model here? Model is for forward bias, simply it will act as a short circuit. For reverse bias, simply it will act as an open circuit. Remember, when we include one by one, one parameter, in second case, we introduce V gamma only. In third case, we introduce two parameters, V gamma and RF. And last class, it is a complete practical diode. It is a complete practical diode having a forward resistance, RF finite, V gamma finite, and RR very large. So this is called the piecewise linear approximation model of a diode. Okay, to solve the problems, we use piecewise linear approximation model of a diode. Okay, when diode is in forward bias, what is the equivalent one is? So this is some battery V gamma, RF diode forward resistance, then anode to cathode. Current flows in this direction, anode to cathode. Okay. Now coming to when diode is in reverse bias is very, very large resistor. Okay, and that this, all these things are replaced with very, very large resistor. So that current flowing through that diode is very, very small. Okay. So this is about the four diode models. Okay. In the problem, depending upon the given condition, suppose the problem itself, consider diode is an ideal diode. Okay. Consider the case one. What is ideal diode characteristics? These are the characteristics. We substitute these two. When diode in forward bias, when diode is in reverse bias. Suppose in the problem, consider a diode is a practical diode. Practical diode means these are the models. What is meant by model? Model is nothing but a replace diode operations with equivalent to some other resistive elements. right? Okay, here observe here, there is no diode symbol here, right? There is no diode symbol in equivalent model. That means diode can be replaced with the help of resistors, capacitors, some voltage sources, etc. So that is a modeling. Modeling is nothing but representing the operation of a diode in forward bias with equivalent resistive elements, resistive, capacitive elements, some voltage source, or sometimes maybe current source also. In this case, resistive and battery. Why? Because once the diode is in the form of resistor or battery, now we can easily apply the KVL or KCL to this loop. Then we can easily find the voltage and current through the device. Okay, that is called the modeling, right? Simply by using a symbol, diode symbol, we cannot very much efficient to apply all these theorems and finding the parameters. Then how to find all these things means, only thing is convert the diode into equivalent models. Modeling is nothing but representing the operation of a diode in terms of resistor, capacitor, and voltage or current sources, right? Okay, that is the one topic. Now coming to the another topic. In last class, we discussed how to find dynamic resistance. Okay, what is formula for dynamic resistance? RF is equal to change in voltage VF by change in current. Okay, change in x-axis by change in current. Then there is a small derivation for this one. The derivation is I is equal to I naught into, okay, already you know, e power, here some textbooks V, VD, okay, all are here V, this V represents the forward voltage. Remember this one, right? I is equal to I naught into e power V by eta VT minus 1. So that is already we derived expression also. Now simplify this one, right? Differentiate with respect to V. Then this is the expression I naught into e power V by eta VT, eta VT. Then what is this ratio V by I by V? I by V is equal to conductance G. Okay, that is equal to 1 by R, right? So conductance G is equal to I naught into this expression. And here some more modifications. In numerator, okay, include minus I naught plus I naught. Now again, take I naught common here. Okay, now this expression, what this one, I naught into e power V by eta VT minus 1, that is a current I. So I plus I naught by eta VT. Remember this one. So take common here I naught, then remaining one is e power V by eta VT minus 1. So then this one is I, current I plus I naught by eta VT. Now, what is the resistance? R is equal to 1 by G. So, eta VT by I plus I. Now, what is the dynamic resistance? dV by dI. That is equal to dynamic resistance. RF is equal to eta VT by I. Why? Because I in forward bias, I very much greater than I naught. So, that what is the expression for dynamic resistance? RF is equal to, remember this one, eta VT by I. Right? Okay, typically the dynamic resistance is very small. You may get maximum 50 ohms, right? Okay, that is a simple derivation for dynamic resistance of a diode or AC forward resistance of a diode. The procedure is very simple, right? Already we derived the expression, current equation. Then only thing is differentiate with respect to V. Then you will get conductance G, then in numerator include add minus I naught plus I naught, then take common I naught, then the simplify. Now the conductance is equal to I plus I naught by eta VT. Now what is the resistance? RF is equal to reverse inverse eta VT by I. We are neglecting the I naught, right? Why? Because in forward bias, the current is very much greater than reverse bias current. The typical value is only around 50 ohms max. Now, diode reverse resistance, reverse is the same DC resistance or DC resistance. DC resistance means only at particular point, reverse voltage by reverse current. Whereas in AC resistance in reverse bias, same. Change in VR by change in IR. But even though here this expression, okay, observe here. This expression we derived using the forward bias expression. Sometimes, okay, not always, sometimes this expression is also used for reverse bias to find reverse resistance. Okay, in reverse resistance, what is here? Simply neglect the I, consider only I naught. In forward bias, we neglected the I naught, consider the I. In reverse bias, simply we neglect I, consider the I naught. So, now what is reverse resistance approximately eta vt by I naught? Right, generally reverse resistance, it is in the range of mega ohms. Remember this one, right? Okay, because it is about diode forward resistance derivation, right? Eta vt by I. If it is a forward resistance, I. If it is a reverse resistance, eta vt by I, right? That is about resistance. Okay, how many students are present here? 72 students. Okay, now here, now onwards mainly concentrate. Why? Because the next topic is diode capacitances, then diode capacitance after that, and again junctions, linear graded junction and step graded junctions. Okay, to derive the diode capacitances, right, first of all you must derive the some electric field and depletion width. Okay, first of all we derive the electric field and depletion width. Once we derive these things, then we can easily understand the derivation for capacitance, diffusion capacitance or transition capacitance. Diffusion capacitance, simple derivation. But coming to the transition capacitance and equilibrium capacitance, right, that is somewhat lengthy procedure, right? Okay, to understand the capacitance derivation, first of all we must derive the electric field and width of a depletion layer in PN junction diode, right? Okay, there is somewhat lengthy derivation, just concentrate, right? Okay, now already we know this figure. What this figure tells, that this is the P type and this is the N type. Okay, consider the mainly depletion region only, right? Depletion region only. When we join the P type material and N type material at nearby junction, in N side positive ions are formed, right? Okay, that is a positive donor ions. Similarly, in P side, negative acceptor ions are formed. Okay, due to this charge, electric field is developed. This field opposes the flow of diffusion current. So that is the second issue, right? Now here is, we have to find the electric field, okay, in terms of all these things. What is this one? Is that WN, width of the depletion region in N side. This is WP, width of the depletion region in P side. What is this one? What is the net charge accumulated in this positive area? ND into Q. Similarly, net charge accumulated in negative area is equal to NA into Q. Right. Okay. Now the derivation starts from using some Gauss law. What Gauss law says? That the net electric field, the change in electric field is equal to charge density by permittivity. Okay, if you not require derivation for this one, this slip by using Gauss law. Gauss law is the relation between the charge density and electric field. Okay, now dE by dx is equal to rho by epsilon, where epsilon again is equal to epsilon naught into epsilon r. Epsilon naught is the permittivity of free space. Okay, now this is the relative permittivity of a material. If we are using some silicon, relative permittivity of a silicon material. Okay, this one is constant E naught, permittivity of a free space. Now, what is from this one simplification, D change in electric field is equal to rho by epsilon into dx. Now, mainly concentrate on this figure only, right? Okay. Now, during the case one, minus Wp less than x less than 0. That means negative field, only this field. What is the net charge here? Rho by epsilon. What is rho? Rho is equal to minus Na. Okay, minus Na into Q by epsilon, right? Minus Na into Q by epsilon. Then differentiate, integrate on both sides. Okay, this expression. Rho is equal to Na into Q, okay, minus Na into Q by epsilon as it is. Then integrate on both sides, you will get electric field. Minus Na, it is a constant. Q electron charge also constant. Permittivity also constant. Okay, only integration of dx is x plus some constant sigma. Now, when x is equal to minus xp, okay, at this point here, when x is equal to minus xp, electric field is equal to 0. Okay, this point electric field is equal to 0. Then substitute this condition and find C1. So E is equal to 0. Then C1 is equal to minus Na into Q into Wp by epsilon. Then again substitute C1 in first expression. Then electric field is equal to minus Na into Q into X by epsilon naught plus minus value of C1 minus NAQ WP by epsilon. Then simplify and take common here. So this is the electric field between minus WP less than X less than G. So minus NAQ by epsilon into X plus WP, right? Now second case. What is second case? During this one, positive area. So what is the electric field? So what is the rho here? Charge density here. What is charge density is equal to Nd into Q. During this one, charge density is equal to number of donor ions into multiplied with charge of an electron. Now here, Nd into Q by epsilon. So the procedure is same. Again, integrate on both sides. Now here the constant is equal to C2. Then how to find constant value is when X is equal to Wn. Observe this diagram. In previous case, when X is equal to minus Wp, electric field is equal to 0. Similarly here, when X is equal to Wn, electric field is equal to 0. So substitute that condition, x is equal to Wn, electric field is equal to 0. From that, find out and also substitute x is equal to Wn, find out C2. Now this is the C2 value. C2 is equal to minus Nd into Q by epsilon into Wn. And again, substitute C2 value in equation 1. So that electric field is equal to Nd into Q by epsilon into X plus minus Nd into Q by epsilon into W. Yeah. Now take common here. Okay. Now electric field is equal to Nd into Q by epsilon X minus Wn. Okay, this is during 0 less than X less than Wn. Yeah. So that electric field is maximum at x is equal to 0. Okay. Now observe here. Electric field is maximum in positive side. It is the maximum at x is equal to 0. And maximum at x is equal to 0 in negative side also. Okay. Actually, when we integrate this one, we get some triangular shape here, right? Here this one triangular, here this one is triangular shape. So that's why the maximum electric field is at x is equal to 0 only. Okay, integration of some step is a triangular like this way. Okay, anyhow, so that maximum electric field is at x is equal to 0, and also for positive side is equal to net charge is equal to 0, so that minus NAQWP by epsilon is equal to minus NDQ by epsilon into WN. So from that we cancel Q and epsilon, then remaining one is NA into WP is equal to ND into WN. So that whatever the charge accumulated here, electric field, total electric field is same. Here this one is NA into WP is equal to NA into WN. Okay, NA into WP is equal to NA into WN. Remember this one. This is called a electric field or charge equality. Okay, and also maximum electric field. Okay, that is electric field derivation here. So maximum electric field is equal to either NA into Q into WP by epsilon or ND into Q into WN by epsilon. Okay, you can consider either this maximum or this, right? Okay. When you simplify net electric field, then that is equal to NA into WP is equal to ND into WN. That is the net. So then if you want to maximum means NA into Q WP one, or other side NA into Q into WN by epsilon. Right? Because this expression we are used some further relationships, right? What is the maximum electric field with respect to WP? Electric field with respect to WN. Okay. Now that is the electric field. Once we derive the electric field, now again derive the width of the depletion region. Okay. Once we know the width of the depletion region, okay, we can easily find the electric built-in potential also. Okay. Now already we know the relation between electric field and voltage. So voltage Vx is equal to minus negative of integral Ax dx. Okay, this is a p-n junction, this is the depletion region width, x is equal to minus WP, x is equal to WN, and the negative N region plus P region minus, so that built-in potential is V naught, right? Here we are considering one assumption here. So this is under equilibrium case, we are not applied any voltage here. So Vn is equal to, okay, sorry, here Vp is equal to 0, but this is reverse. Vp is equal to 0, Vn is equal to V naught. Okay, this is the current. Okay, Vp is equal to 0, Vn is equal to V naught. Now consider the, already we derived the electric field. Okay, already we derived the electric field. Between this region minus WP less than X less than 0. So what is electric field here? First case. Okay, this is the first case. So electric field in this region minus WP less than X less than 0. So minus NA into Q by epsilon X plus WP. Right? And substitute here. Okay, minus NA Q by epsilon X plus WP into dx. Okay, in all these cases only integrations only, and again integrate here with respect to dx here. This is x. X means x square by 2, x plus WP by 2, then again there is a constant C1, then how to find the constant C1? Observe here, when x is equal to minus Wp and the voltage is equal to 0. So substitute the condition. When x is equal to minus Wp, voltage is equal to 0. So here x is equal to minus Wp. Minus Wp plus Wp, right? It is equal to 0, 0 square, 0, 0. Everything is 0, then C1. Here left hand side also 0, C1 is equal to 0. Now substitute C1 value here. Now what is Vx? Voltage Na cube by epsilon into x plus Wp whole square by 2. This is between the range. Minus Wp less than x less than 0. Similarly, find the voltage. Okay, similarly find the voltage between this range 0 less than x less than Wn. Okay, what is electric field here? Electric field is equal to Nd cube by epsilon x minus Wn. Same integrate here. Then how to find the constant C2 value? C2 is equal to, when x is equal to Wn, what is the voltage? Built-in potential is equal to V0. Observe here. This is the condition. This is not correct. Sorry. So when x is equal to Wn, okay, voltage is equal to V0, where V0 is the built-in potential. Okay, already we derived the built-in potential in terms of some other parameters. Now here we derive the built-in potential in terms of depletion width, etc. Right. Now substitute that condition. When x is equal to Wn, Vx is equal to V0. Okay, then substitute that condition. Then you will get the Vx is equal to minus Nd cube by epsilon at x minus Wn whole square plus V0. Right? Okay. Now at x is equal to 0, V0 is the same. At x is equal to 0, whatever the voltage is equal to same. Then 3 is equal to 4. Equate these two voltages. Na into q by 2 epsilon wp whole square is equal to minus nd q by 2 epsilon wn whole square plus v0. Just simply substitute x is equal to 0 in third equation and fourth equation. That is the condition. What is the condition here? X is equal to 0. So that again further simplify here. This V0 is equal to, take this side. Okay. Now from, again observe this PN junction, this one. What is the total width? The total width is equal to Wp plus Wn. Right? Okay. Now observe here. Why? Because all these are used in further equations also. Further equation derivations also, capacitor derivations. Right. Wp plus Wn is equal to total width. Now, here, what is the condition here? Okay, charge equality condition is equal to Nd into Wp is equal to Na into Wp. Okay, already we derived this one in electric field. Okay, Nd into W. N is equal to Na into Wp, right? First case, already we derived this one. Okay, this one. Na into Wp is equal to Nd into Wn. Okay, electric field. The net electric field is equal to same. So then we derive the one expression as Na into Wp is equal to Nd into Wn. Use this one. Okay, Nd into Wn is equal to Na into Wp. Okay, from this one, what is Wn is equal to W minus Wp, and Wn is equal to W. From this, calculate the Wp. Wp is equal to Nd Wn by Na. Then take this side, then Wn. Okay, Wn in terms of W and Na and Nd. Similarly, same WP is equal to W into Nd by Na plus Nd. Okay. Once again here, width of the depletion region is WP plus WN is equal to W. Then one more net equality is electric field equality is equal to NdWn is equal to NaW. From the first one here, Wn is equal to W minus Wp. Now Wp, okay, by using this equality equation, Wp is equal to NdWn by Na. Then simplify, you will get Wn is equal to W into Na by Na plus Nd. Similarly, Wp is equal to W into Nd by Na plus Nd. Right. Now here, what is V naught here? Okay. This is the V naught expression. V naught is equal to Q by 2 epsilon Na Wp plus Nd Wn whole square. Okay, substitute here Wp or Wn with respect to this one. Then simplify here. Then Wp is equal to Nd into Wn into Wp here. Then simplify. Then you get finally, on further simplification. Okay. And finally, you will get is V naught built-in potential V naught is equal to Q by 2 epsilon W square Na Nd by Na plus Nd. Right? Okay, these two are important. This is the built-in potential expression in terms of Q, W, Na, Nd, epsilon. Right? Now from that W, from that width is equal to, okay, take all these terms other side, width is equal to 2 epsilon by Q Na plus Nd by Na into Nd into P. Right? Now, W is equal to further simplification, 2 epsilon by Q into, okay, simplify this one, 1 by Na plus 1 by Nd into V0. Why you can write like this means we can use this expression in linear graded and step graded junctions, right? Okay, in step graded junction, what happens means the doping is not a constant, right? If it is Na very much greater than Nd or Na very much less than Nd. In this case, we can neglect one term, either 1 by Na or 1 by Nd. But that's why we can write this W width expression in the form of 2 epsilon by Q, 1 by Na plus 1 by Nd into V naught. Suppose we are using the, where epsilon is the permittivity of the material. Suppose we are using silicon. So W is equal to root 2 into simply a suffix add SI, silicon, right? 2 epsilon SI by Q into 1 by Na plus 1 by Nd into V0, right? Okay, where V0 is built-in potential. Or some textbooks, Vj, Vj is the junction potential. Okay, all are same meaning, right? Okay, remember here, this one is V naught is built-in potential V naught, or some textbooks Vj. Now we derived two expressions. One is V naught built-in potential in terms of Q by 2 epsilon omega square Na Nd by Na plus Nd. From this, again we derived another expression. Width is equal to 2 epsilon Q by Na plus Nd by Na Nd into V naught. All are under root only, right? Where V naught is the built-in potential or junction potential. We are not applying any bias. We are not applying any bias voltage, right? Okay. Again, there is a one more relation. Okay. Now, in sometimes in the examinations, if I ask relation between the electric field V naught and W, right? Okay, what is electric field maximum? Maximum electric field is equal to Nd into Q by Wn by epsilon, and again Wn is equal to W by Na plus Nd, right? This one W by Na plus Nd, then simplify this one. Okay, now W, already we derived the W expression. Okay, substitute here W expression and take these terms into roots, and finally we got this relation. That relation is maximum electric field is equal to 2 V naught by W, right? Okay, this is the important relation between built-in potential and width and electric field, right? And suppose we apply some forward bias. Now this built-in potential is reduces. How much reduces? V naught minus Vf. Okay, V naught minus Vf. Suppose we are using some reverse bias, V naught plus Vr. Okay, like that only. Okay, in forward bias means this V naught is replaced with V naught minus Vf. In reverse bias, V naught plus Vr. Okay. Okay, in gate examination or some other competitive examinations, okay, this relation is important. Suppose you given some electric field, multiple choice questions, electric field is equal to 2 V naught by W, right? This is the one relation. Okay, okay, so far we derived the 5 to 6 expressions. One is the electric field. This one is the first one. Okay, charge equality here. Na into Wp is equal to Nd into Wn. Whatever may be the case, okay, the product of Na into Wp is equal to Nd into Wn. Remember this one. So that maximum electric field in one side, right? Na into Q by Wp by epsilon. Or in other side, Nd into Q into Wn by epsilon. Okay, based on this equations, we derived the width of the depletion region as well as built-in potential of the depletion region, right? And in between, we are converting Wn in terms of W by Na by Na plus Nd, Wb, W into Nd by Na plus Nd. Right. So finally, we derived two equations. V naught is equal to built-in potential. V naught is equal to Q by 2 epsilon W square Na Nd by Na plus Nd. Now W is equal to 2 epsilon Si by Q 1 by Na plus 1 by Nd into V naught. Okay, all are this under root only, right? Okay, this is about width of a p-n junction derivation, and there is a one more relation. That relation is relation between width and electric field and V naught. Electric field is equal to 2 V naught by width, right? Okay, all these derivations are useful for finding the capacitance. Finding the capacitance, p-n junction diode capacitance, right? Okay, how many are there? Okay, still 69 are there. Only 50% students are present, right? Now we go to the junctions, right? Okay, there are two junctions mainly used in p-n junction. One is the step graded junction, okay, also called abrupt junction, right? And second one is the linear graded junction. Just here I am not going in detail here, just we are giving concept, right? Next class also we continue with the step graded junction and remaining junction. Observe here. If the doping concentration is the main in step graded junction, is doping concentration, donor, number of donor atoms is not equal to number of acceptor atoms. Remember this one. Doping concentration is not same in step graded junction or abrupt junction. That means there is a change in doping concentration. Now what happened means two possibilities. Nd greater than Na, that means donor atoms are greater than Na acceptor atoms. That means N side greater than P side. That means N side heavily doped. N side highly doped or heavily doped. Then we can say that diode is PN plus diode. Because some examinations, instead of given PN diode, they given PN plus diode. What is meant by N plus here? What is meant by N plus? That means the doping concentration of N side is greater than the doping concentration of P side. Right? Similarly here, second possibility is ND less than NA. ND less than NA. That means here P side. P side is heavily doped. Okay. So that's why P plus N diode. Okay. That means acceptor atoms are greater than donor atoms. Now what type of diode results? Diode is P plus N. P plus the P type or P side is heavily doped. Right. Okay. Okay. These are the step graded junction or abrupt junction. Here the main point is, in this case, doping concentration is not same. Doping concentration is unequal. Remember this one. Two possibilities, ND greater than NA, then resultant junction is PN plus diode, and ND less than AA, P plus N diode. Now what is the charge equality equation? Whatever may be the junction, this is the, this should be constant. WP into NA is equal to WN into ND. Already we derived in previous tests, right? Already we derived in electric field derivation, WN into ND is equal to WP into N. Now what happened means, observe here junction. When ND greater than NA, okay, donor side greater than NA, okay, N side heavily doped. When N side heavily doped means the width of the depletion region is very, very small, right? Width of the depletion region is very, very small. When the doping level is less, acceptor level, the depletion region width is high. Remember this one, right? Whenever the doping level is high, remember this one, doping level is high, in depletion region what happened? Width is very, very small. Doping level is low, width of the depletion region is very, very high. This is for PN plus diode. Now this is P plus N diode. Now what happened here? P plus P side depletion region is very, very small. N side depletion region is very, very high. Remember this one, right? Inversely proportional. If it is a heavily doped, N side is heavily doped, what happened means the width of the depletion region is very, very small. Heavily doped, so that the, all atoms are penetrated into towards the junction, so that the width is very, very small, whereas here the width is large. Now here consider the P plus N diode. NA very much greater than ND. Already we derived the width, okay, under root 2 epsilon SI Q by 1 by NA plus 1 by ND into V. Now in this case what happened? NA very much greater than ND. That's why we neglect 1 by N. So that remaining one is W is equal to 2 epsilon SI Q by 1 by N A into P. Right? That's why we express the W expression in terms of 1A or 1 by N A plus 1 by N A into V. Remember this one. Then W is equal to WN plus WP. So W approximately equal to WN in this case only. Why? Because P side is heavily doped. So W approximately equal to W. Suppose PN plus diode. Okay. Okay, here in this expression only ND. Then W approximately equal to WP. Okay. This is about step graded junction. Right? Here the main concept here in step graded junction is that doping concentration is not equal. One side is heavily doped, another side is lightly doped. Okay, how it formation, right? What are the impurity atoms are added to form a step graded junction? Okay, all these things discussed in next class, right? Thank you all. Thank you very much for joining the class, right? Till the end of the class, only 60 students are active only, right? That means only less than 50%, less than 50% students are attended. Why remaining people are active, I don't know, but all these derivations on these classes are very, very important, right? Once you understand this class, then only you can easily understand the derivation of PN junction diode capacitance, right? Why? Because in PN junction diode capacitance, directly we use W expression. W is equal to under root 2 epsilon Q by 1 by Na plus 1 by Nd into V naught. Like that, we derive the junction capacitance expressions, right? Okay, I think 50% our students are not available here at the end of the class. I request you, okay, please ask them to attend the online classes. Otherwise, it is very difficult, right? Already you know that networks and ADC is a fundamental subjects, right? Okay, thank you. You may leave the class. Thank you. And before attending a class, try to watch previous class video lecture. I will upload in afternoon session, right? Okay, try to convey your friends, please attend the class, or otherwise watch the previous class video lecture. Thank you very much. Thank you.